Ava.
And I'm Cameron.
We're from Mrs. Atkins' third grade class.
Here they are now reciting a holiday poem.
"'Twas the night before Christmas, all through the house, not a single creature stirring, not even a mouse.
The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas would soon be there.
The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama and Kerchief and I made cap had just settled down for a long winter's nap.
When out on the lawn there was such a clatter, when I sprang up from my bed to see what was the matter.
Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and through the sash.
The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave the luster of midday to objects below, when what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and eight tiny reindeer.
With little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles, his cursors they came, and he whistled and shouted and called by name. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all!
As dry leaves that before the hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky.
So up to the housetop the coursers they flew, with a bagload hoisting St. Nicholas too.
And then in a twinkle I heard on the roof the fencing upon a vista hill. As I drew in my head and was turning round, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound.
He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot. His clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot.
A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack.
His eyes, how they twinkled, his cheeks, his dimples, how merry, his cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry.
The stump of a pipe he held in his teeth, and the smoke encircled his head like a leaf.
His jaw and mouth was drawn up like a bow, his beard and his chin was white as snow.
He had a broad face, a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly.
He was chubby and plump, a right jolly elf, old elf, and I laughed when I saw him, like in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and the twist of his head soon led me to know I knew some strength.
He spoke not a word, but went straight to his fork and filled all stockings and turtles with dirt.
And laying his finger aside of his nose, giving a nod of the chimney he rose.
He sprang to the sled, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle.
But I heard him in his sleep as he drove out of sight, Merry Christmas to all and to all a good night.
Good morning, Fairlands Flyers, and welcome back to another episode of FTV. This is Lulu.
And Nolan.
Anchoring the final episode of 2017. How exciting!
Our friendly fifth graders just recently went on a field trip to see the movie Wonder.
Here's Siona and Harini taking a closer look at the movie.
Hi everyone, it's Siona and Harini.
Reporting live from Regal Cinemas. Smell that, Siona? What do you smell?
Hi, Sean.
Popcorn?
Not just popcorn, Siona. Creamy, savory pop kernels fit perfectly for my taste buds.
Anyway, the fifth graders are here to see the new movie, Wonder.
This movie is about a kid named Augie who has facial differences.
Mandibuloacral facial dysostosis is the name of the facial condition.
Yep, this story has great messages about kindness, friendship, acceptance. We're so excited to see it.
Yes, we're going in. Bye, everyone!
So, Chris, what lessons can we all learn from Wonder?
I think that we can all learn that kindness is the way that the world can heal itself. If there's a problem, the only way to solve it, or the main way to solve it that can help us all, is with kindness. There's no problem in the world that cannot be fixed with kindness. So, moral of the story, be kind.
Hi, Savannah. For the Wonder movie, what was your favorite part?
My favorite part was when they were at Via's play, because it showed when Miranda said she wasn't feeling well, she gave Via a chance to show how great she was, and everyone saw like how her theater skills were very good, and everyone loved how she was in the play.
I like that part too.
Now it's time for the final trivia of 2017.
We're going to be playing fill in the blank. Try to guess the word that goes in the blank space.
When given the choice between being right and being kind, choose...
A, right.
B, kind.
Or C, choose whatever your friends choose.
If you guessed B, you are correct. Always choose kind when given the chance.
Now here's Tyler and Alex doing a story on our wonderful leadership team.
Hello, Fairlands Flyers. Today we're here with Ella, the Fairlands School President.
Hi, Fairlands.
So Ella, what encouraged you to join leadership?
Well, my mom wanted my last year to be the best for me because this is obviously my last year and I just wanted to, you know, help people out in the school.
So who helped you, like, with your application, or did you do it by yourself?
Actually, my friend Ashlyn helped me a lot because she was in leadership last year and she just helped me with my speech and everything, so yeah.
So how much do you like leadership?
I like it a lot. We get to do really fun stuff like flag salutes and put together events.
All right, thank you, Ella.
Mm-hmm.
Today we have Ewan from leadership.
Hello.
So Ewan, what encouraged you to be in leadership?
Well, I have always liked giving speeches and I've always liked leading. I realized that the speeches part was never going to go, but I realized that I had a chance to lead and lead by example.
Great. Well, like, do you like it or do you wish you would have changed mine?
I really do enjoy it a lot of the time. It's nice to be able to plan things that are going to take place later on. It's also nice to know that people will look up to you sometimes.
Hello, Fairlands Flyers. Today we're here with Cassidy from leadership.
Well, Cassidy, what encouraged you to join leadership?
I wanted to help the community and make the school a better place.
Okay, so do you like being in leadership or do you wish you changed your mind?
I enjoy being in leadership.
Okay.
What are some excitements that you have? Like, or anything you were hoping to do or anything you were kind of hoping you wouldn't do?
I was excited when we walked through the parade for the holiday parade.
Okay. Is there anything that you wish you could do that you're not doing?
We didn't get a chance to do adopt a family this month because of the other things that we were doing.
Okay, thank you. That's all we have today, Fairlands Flyers. Back to you, Nolan and Lulu.
Bye.
Now it's time for the last shout-out of 2017.
This week's shout-out goes to Miss Raymond and Mrs. Collison.
These two amazing teachers have always done a great job helping our leadership team organize events and flag salutes.
Thank you for your contribution, Miss Raymond and Mrs. Collison.
Every year, it is a tradition to make a New Year's resolution.
Here's Karina and Marina interviewing kids for their New Year's resolution.
So what are your New Year's resolution goals?
Probably at home I would like to read more, and at school I definitely like to be learning a lot more than I already am.
So why did you choose these goals?
Because I've always wanted to read at home a lot more than I already have. That's kind of just the reason why. And at school I'm really good at what I'm already learning, so I'd like to learn more.
Okay, thank you.
What are your goals for the New Year's?
My goal for the New Year's is not to get Fs for math especially, because if I do bad in math, I'll probably get grounded. So, yeah.
So why did you choose these goals?
Well, not getting Fs is because I don't want to disappoint my parents and for middle school, so that the middle school could see that I'm a good student.
And thank you. So what are your New Year's goals for the new year?
I'll try not to fight with my sister or, like, get any, like, bad stuff.
So why did you choose this goal?
Well, I always fight with my sister and then I get in trouble. And that's pretty much it.
Thank you.
So what are your goals for the New Year's?
Oh, boy. I have so many, but one is to drink more water. I don't drink enough water every day. And another one is to read more books, because I love reading, but I want to read some books for pleasure. So that's another one.
So why did you choose these goals?
Oh, because I think they're ways to help me keep healthier, stay healthier, get healthier. Yeah, ways to take care of myself, grow my mind, and take care of my body. Thank you.
This episode, Elliot will be doing his last enlightenment of 2017.
We're going to see Elliot talking about New Year's resolutions, and here he is.
Happy New Year's! The
the best time of the year. You get a fresh start, and you might want to make resolution or goals for yourself. If anyone doesn't know what a resolution is, they should know that by now. A resolution is a goal you make to have a fresh start towards the New Year's. As for me, I plan on completing my classwork to make Mrs. Like happy and to continue showing compassion towards everyone I see. I wonder what your New Year's resolution is. Well, I may not know what your resolution is, but I know how to end this thing by saying, have a good day.
Before we go, we have a special announcement from Mrs. Galletti.
And from one of her special first grade friends.
Hi, Fairlands. I'm here with Abby from first grade, Mrs. Green's class. Shout out to Mrs. Green's class. And Angela from Mrs. Reset's class. Shout out to Mrs. Reset's class. I'm always looking for ways in which we can calm ourselves down. On Wednesday mornings, we often practice our belly breaths. Abby, though, has taught me another way that we can calm down. She's going to teach us it, and then Angela and I are going to practice it. Abby, can you explain to us what it is and what you do?
So, I do my shark fin. You raise your hand in front of your face, and you put your body like this.
So, you put your hands up like a shark fin. Go ahead and follow me, Angela. And then you breathe out as it goes down. Wow, that is a great way to calm yourself down. Let's all try it again together. Ready? Shark fin up. All right, so boys and girls, remember, during this busy time, we are sometimes forgetting to follow our three B's. When that happens, take a moment, belly breath or your shark fin, and refocus yourself to do the right thing and make the right choice. Okay?
Thanks so much for watching the last, but certainly not least, episode of 2017.
We hope you have a great winter break.
Fly like a bird.
And stay fresh, Fairlands Flyers.
Lightning and the thunder. Thunder, thunder. Feel the thunder. Lightning and the thunder.
It's not unusual to be loved by anyone.